kama kungekuwa na njia ya kudeal nayo kabisa iishe, mimi ningetaka imalizwe kabisa.
FGM is an outlawed vice that is no longer acceptable in society. It's outlawed by the Anti-FGM Act of 2011, and all communities in this region are aware of that law.
FGM is one of the worst violations against the child. For instance, this one has both physical, psychological, and and sexual impact on the life of the child. For instance, there are very bad health repercussions that are associated with FGM. Hemorrhage is one of the worst forms, one of the worst effects. Bleeding, and sometimes these procedures are undertaken in very unhygienic conditions, and there's no anesthesia. There's, a lot of times the children end up dying after the procedures if these are not properly taken care of. This then follows that our meager medical resources are strained because children have to be taken to hospital, and more so these are families that previously may not have had enough money as resources.
If I was somewhere to do something, I would have done it faster and with a lot of vigor.
So again, other than the actual physical impact, you have a lot of social impacts that result from FGM.
Watoto wetu wanakuanga na vichwa ngumu. Hawasikii sasa wapati hawataki kusikia maagizo ya wazazi wetu. Wanawaza unajua akitairiwa anaona ni kama analingana na mtu yeyote ile hata awe mkubwa.
When that time used to reach, tulikuwa tunaekwa kwa nyumba unafungwa, because my dad, kwa familia yetu, my dad hakuwa anataka to undergo circumcision sisi watoto wake wa kike. So tulikuwa tunafungiwa kwa nyumba. Hiyo season ikifika, we are told hakuna kwenda kwa jirani kukula wakati wamefanya hizo sherehe, because they believe kuna ile ule uchawi wa wanafanya wakati chakula kimepikwa. Unapata umewekewa nyama saba, ukikula uzimalize, you're told utakufa. So we are not allowed to kutembea, kuokota kitu chochote. Anything that is in 7-7, kipata mashilingi saba, don't pick. Kipata noti zimetupwa, don't pick. Wakati ya watoto wametairiwa, we are not, ukitembea barabarani, utapatana na wao. Most of them are arrogant, watakupiga, ama watakutukana, watukane, ikue vita.
From the local, from the locality, it is something that is prestigious, eh? It is a culture, as they put it, eh? And everybody wants it. So anybody who goes against the culture, obviously you have to be a different person. You have to be sorry, but I have to use this, kind of a bad omen. Okay, so we can't say there is no stigmatization
in school. Like the public schools, I went through a boarding school where hawange to discriminate. Instead, walikuwa wana feel discriminated. So, kwa hizi public schools, ndio walikuwa hawa watu wenye hawajakuwa circumcised wanakuwa discriminated. Because unapata the biggest number ni wenye wako circumcised na wenye wana embrace. So, utapata wale wanakuwa discriminated to an extent that wezi kana watoto wenzako, who can't tell stories. The moment ukienda pale, they only mock you, wakuchekele, and such like.
FGM is used as a rite of passage in Korea. So you realize that there's a small girl has a name, a girl who has not been initiated into adulthood. So like for this girl, there's this term, Musagane. So when this term is very humiliating, and when you are called Musagane at the age of 15, 16 or even 20, it refers to somebody who is still, you are still a child, that childhood thing. So it's a common name for the girls who have not undergone FGM.
Wanaitwa Musagane mara nyingi sana. I don't feel any effect. Si feel effect. Kwa sababu hata ukiniita hivyo upstairs, mimi sio Musagane. I could be Musagane easy areas zenye unafikiria, but upstairs I'm okay. So unaniita hivyo, I just laugh, smile, walk away.
So in school, we try as much as possible for this term to be eradicated, to disappear completely, so that such that we give a lot of, we regard girls that have not undergone this, we give them much more, we reward them, we give them this kind of, they should outstand. So we give them opportunities, we give them, we make them look better than these ones. We give them that, you know, the support, the thing to make them feel, in fact, they are better than the ones who did it. So anytime anybody who did it or anybody who is for it tries to intimidate this other person, we make sure we take proper action.
I'm woman enough, because at Eva, I was able to conceive, I have a kid. Yeah, so sioni tofauti. I'm educated. Whatever thing they can do, I think I can do it better. Those who underwent FGM.
Because we've had these child rights clubs, this is where we sensitize them, we give them, we shed light on what is this FGM. Yes, it is our culture, but then we give them this category of, we call them retrogressive cultural practices. These are negative cultural practices. Yeah, even though it is a cultural practice, it is our culture, yes, but it is negative. It is retrogressive. It is not taking us anywhere. It is doing us more harm than good. So we let these kids, leave alone the elders, the mamas, the old mamas, old babas, who still value it for a culture. So we've gone back down to these kids. We are giving them the sense that this thing, in as much as it has been there, it was done, it has been done, to us, the young generation, the child himself, give her sense, tell her the negativity, the effects, the negative effects of this FGM. So they grow up knowing, in as much as it is there, as a person, I have the problem, I have consequences to face as a person. So they grow up with the sense that FGM is not right in as much as it has been there.
They don't share out their experiences because they it's like they shy away. Sababu wamekuja kugundua whatever thing they did, some of them labda walifanywa bila kujua sio nzuri au ni nzuri. So wakati huu wamekuja kugundua haikuwa nzuri, na wengi ambao tuko pamoja wanaona afadhali kumbe singetairiwa, ningekaa kama huyu. So ni ngumu sana mtu akwambie hata nimetairiwa ama sijatairiwa. Lakini kwa wale ambao unajua, the moment you raise the issue, mnakosana. So they don't speak out.
There's a very strong correlation between FGM practice and education. You know, for example, most of the victims of FGM are young girls who are in puberty age. Usually these are girls who are still in primary school. And what normally happens is that immediately a girl has undergone FGM, a lot of times they feel they are now mature, they are old enough to get married, they start engaging in sexual activities probably, and many of them would end up getting involved in early marriages, and once a girl is married, definitely they'll not go to school.
Enyewe watoto wetu hawa wakipashwa tohara, hawa wasichana wetu wakikuria, iko shida mingi tunapata huko kwa ground. Hawa wasichana mara ya kwanza unajua kipashwa tohara ni kama amehitimu sasa, hata wewe 13 years hana uoga wa kuongea, hata anaweza ongea na mzee wa miaka 50. Sasa yeye ni mtu ambaye amekoma.
Na unapata majority wenye wali undergo FGM, wengi wakisha tairi, wanafidiwa na mawazo kwamba wao wamesha fikia ile age ya kuwa mama, unaweza ukawa na mwanaume, unaweza ukazaa, unaweza ukafanya kazi kama vile mamako anafanya. So akisha tairiwa akae kidogo, anaolewa.
Unajua pa, wakati ule wa sherehe anaambiwa kila kitu. Wale wa mama wanachesa pale, wanampeleka kwa boma. Wanamwambia sasa umekuwa mke, unasaoleka na mtu yeyote ile, awe mzee wa miaka 60, awe hata 80 atakuoa ama lika yako. So usiwe na uoga. Na umehitimu sasa kila kitu.
And again, a girl who has undergone FGM would not feel comfortable sitting with others in the same class, and a lot of times you'll see them opting to leave school at that early age.
Full dropout is equal. So mtoto akienda huko anakuwa na kichwa ngumu. Msichana akipigwa kiboko na madam, anamwangalia sasa, after all mimi ni I'm ready, nimeiva. Sasa huyo ananipiga kwa nini? Unajua hiyo tu ana drop out.
Minority ndio wanakaa kidogo, wanavumilia, wanasoma, wanamaliza. Ya, lakini wengi wao wakisha tayari tu kidogo, miaka kidogo, hata wengine wamalizi, wakisha wamaliza ile wanasema kuna term inatumika kwa Kuria yenye nimesahau kidogo. Ukishafanya hizo sherehe zao wamalize, amepona. Wengine wavumili, they go.
Most of our girls through these, in these families that practice, you realize most of the girls will drop out of school. The girls, most of them will not reach the education level that is meant to bring, to uplift their families. So at the end of the day, they remain there. So the families lag behind. Why? Because their girls will drop out of school, majorly because after initiation you are assumed to be a big girl. So marriage, there is a lot of child marriages, a lot of early pregnancies, child pregnancies, drop school dropouts, and such kind of things. So you realize while these enlightened families take their kids to school, these other diehards of FGM lose their girls after FGM. So at the end of the day, they can never be at par.
The chiefs and the assistant county commissioners have instructions to ensure that all children within the areas of jurisdiction go to school. But considering the rural nature of the environment here, it is not possible to achieve 100%. The actively FGM practicing families go out of their way to hide these children from public sight.
Nowadays they hide. They do this, they undertake these FGM activities at night. So sometimes it becomes a challenge to arrest the circumcisers.
These girls are normally hidden from us. But basically we are encouraging and we are using the local NGOs, the NGOs that are operating around, so that they go out and seek to inform this girl of their rights, so that these girls can be able on their own to say, no, I don't want to undergo the cut, and they present themselves to the local administration.
One of the strategies that we have in place is what we call community dialogues. We are holding dialogues with communities. We are trying to advocate against FGM. We are educating them on the dangers of FGM. And again, we are working very closely with the local leadership so that we are engaging with them with a view to ensuring that they discourage the practice of FGM.
We are also incorporating boys, because you know boys wamekuwa pia instruments of intimidation and discrimination and stigmatization. So we incorporate boys in our talks, in our sensitization meetings, so that even boys are our ambassadors out there. They don't want their sisters to go, they support them. They don't want their classmates and friends and village mates to go, they support them. So in as much as it is a threat, we have some confidence.
Kwanza ni ku create awareness, kufundisha jamii yetu kwa njia ya kimungu kanisani na kwenye pia kwa mikutano, kwenye seminars, kuna kwenye workshops tunafundisha hata vijana wetu ubaya wa kukeketa wasichana, kwa sababu msichana anapokeketwa ni kama kumpunguzia ile haki yake ya kimungu, ya kibinadamu ambayo Mungu alimuumbia. Ile sehemu ambayo wanakata, ile sehemu Mungu aliweka pale makusudi, ni kama vile mtu anaweza kuja kung'oa meno, na wakati utakapofikia wakati wa kula mfupa, meno yote imeng'olewa, utakuwa mtu amekunyima haki yako ambayo Mungu alikuombea. Kwa hivyo tunajaribu kuelimisha hata vijana wetu pia kwamba waoe wasichana wale ambao hawajakeketwa.
It has no value in the real sense. It is taking us nowhere. Actually, it is doing us more harm than good. Kindly say no to FGM. Stop FGM.
Jamii, community yetu inaona kama kanisa linaingilia mila yao ambayo wameobserve kwa miaka mingi. Sasa huwa wanajaribu sana kujaribu kushawishi watu kuwa kinyume, kwa sababu wamekuwa kiambia watu kwamba ukikosa kukeketwa huwezi kuolewa kwa mujibu wa Kikuria. Hiyo tumegundua watu wetu wale ambao sasa, kama kwa mfano mimi, watoto wangu sita, wasichana wangu hawajakeketwa, wawili wameolewa, wawili tena sasa wako university, wanamaliza mwaka huu. na tayari wako na wachumba. Kwa hivyo hiyo ndio shida ilikuwa inaambia watu kwamba ukikosa kukeketwa utaolewa, wameolewa.
Most of them do not have the facts. It is just that thing of our culture. When there are many, they say it is our culture. But you face one person, believe you me, this person doesn't have any good reasons, any clear reasons as to why it should be done. It is just that it is our culture, full stop. Apart from that, nothing clear.
Those practicing and promoting FGM are not keen on the traditional value of FGM, but they are keen on the monetary aspect. Because to circumcise one girl, the family pays 1,000 shillings. You can imagine circumcising 3,000 girls means somebody somewhere is going to earn 3 million shillings.
In the community setting, there are these special people involved. Like for example, the aunt. This aunt, they are grooming the girl. Like they have some sort of education, some sort of trainings they give to the girl. So this aunt is not doing this because it's a good practice to the girl, but because at the end of the day, she will be given kangas. She will be rewarded for doing a good job, for training the girl. Then as the celebration continues, there are people rewarding with some cash. The cash is thrown on the girl, you know, such kind of things. So the aunt, because she's the closest and she's the responsible, just that, like the baptismal parents, they are responsible. They are the responsible parents as at that point.
Hatuoni kama serikali inatusaidia. Ikifi, maana ni sheria imepitishwa kwamba ukeketaji wa wasichana ni kinyume cha sheria, ilipitishwa. Lakini sasa inapofika, inapotokea, unakuta kwamba hata serikali ambayo yenye ingekuwa mstari wa mbele, unakuta wanaanza kurudisha mkono nyuma, wanaanza kurudi nyuma. Hasa ndio tunabaki sisi wenyewe. Sasa inakuwa shida, hata kama unashika mtu, hata ukigundua mtu hako hapo na unaambia polisi ama chief, unaona hakuna hatua inachukuliwa. Sasa na wewe mwenyewe kama raia uwezi kwenda kushika mtu.
These chiefs find it very very difficult because they are members of the community and they fear. They fear that in case they arrest these people, then they are likely to be attacked by members of the community.
We strongly believe that one of the best approaches still remains advocacy. So that while we're working closely with the local leadership, then we must engage the community directly through advocacy and through community dialogues. And thereby we hope that ultimately they will be able to change their perspectives in regard to this practice.
The government may not have the resources, the needed resources to be able to carry out FGM, anti-FGM campaigns. I would advise parents to take responsibility of their children. I would advise parents to make sure they are very, very responsible.
FGM is not a good thing. Kama kungekuwa na njia kudeal nayo kabisa iishe, mimi ningetaka imalizwe kabisa.
You know, you can put them through some kind of training, through some kind of education, something that will ultimately add value to their lives and make them understand that much as FGM was one of the practices that would make them transcend from childhood to adulthood, there are other modes or other ways through which this can be done other than the physical mutilation. Leaders must come out strongly, especially in political leadership. We would not like to see a situation where politicians would not want to come out strongly against FGM, probably for fear of losing votes. Equally, we have individuals who are from this community who are already out there, and because probably they're already senior in government, they would like to intimidate the local legal fraternity or the local law enforcing agencies, especially when some of their relatives who are still practicing this are caught up with by the law.
Kijana wangu mwenye amemaliza university, nikamwambia ukioa msichana mwenye hajatahiriwa nitakuwa furaha kubwa kabisa, na ameni promise. Kwa hivyo watu community kiona kwamba mtoto wangu ameoa msichana mwenye ambaye hakukeketwa na msichana ambaye amesoma, hiyo pia inafanya wale wasichana wengine wanakuwa na imani kwamba kumbe hata mimi nikikosa kukeketwa hata naweza kuolewa.
Tunaomba, kwa naomba jamii yetu ya Wakuria kwa jumla, kitu cha kwanza watoto wetu tuwashikirie. Ya pili watoto wetu waende shule. Ya tatu watoto wetu wakimaliza mashule sasa unajua sasa wanakuwa watu wazima wanakuja kutusaidia hapo kwa boma zetu wakiwa wameng'ara kielimu naomba wa jamii yetu tuachane na mila na desturi ambayo inaumiza watoto wetu kama hii ya wasichana. Hiyo ni mila potofu. Kwa naomba jamii yetu kwa jumla wa Kuria wazima na wengine ambayo wako kategori hiyo, tuachane na hiyo mila potofu.
Stop FGM. Let us educate our children. Empower girl child, you have empowered a whole nation. Kindly, let us stop FGM. Let us empower girl children. Take them to school, educate them, give them the best. Empowered girl child equals to an empowered nation, equals to empowered community, equals to empowered generation.